Hello students, welcome to the next class of dynamics. Today we are going to discuss on the next concept, that is superelevation. So superelevation is generally provided wherever there is a change in the direction. Okay, what is this? We'll understand. So whenever a vehicle is traveling along the straight road and if it has to change its direction without compromising its speed, what happens is whenever a vehicle is taking a turn, the person inside the vehicle will experience an outward pull. So this outward pull is because of the centrifugal force that is trying to pull the vehicle away from the road, right? So if you see the third figure here, the vehicle centrifugal force is there. Centrifugal force is acting outwards and centripetal force is inwards. Now, to eliminate that effect of outward pull, which will cause two types of failure on the vehicles, those are what? One is failure because of skidding and one is failure because of overturning. So what we do here is the road is raised a little bit on the higher side at the outer edge without disturbing the inner edge. That is, the outer edge of the pavement is elevated above the inner edge. This rising of outer edge above inner edge by certain amount is what is called as super elevation. Okay, we'll understand that clearly here. So I have drawn a certain stretch of road. When the vehicle approaches from this side, from the left hand side towards the curve, you can see that the road on the upper side is what is written as outer edge, the inner side is the inner edge. So if at section 1-1, if I take the cross section of the road, you can see that the thickness of the road on outer edge and inner edge is same. As I approach towards the circular curve, what I'm doing is refer the section 2-2, the outer edge is being increased a little bit without changing anything with respect to the inner edge. At section 3-3, which is the deepest point of the curve, you can see that the maximum height is attained, which is nothing but the super elevation. Again, as the curve depletes, you can see at section 4-4, the outer edge is reduced, and at 5-5, which is a straight road, the outer edge and inner edge are again same. So if you refer section 1-1 and 5-5, both are same. Right, so the super elevation is related with respect to the curve where it is provided. Okay, now what is a, to have a better understanding of this super elevation, let us have a look at this animation. So you'll have a clear picture. Now see, the vehicle is traveling along a straight road and it takes a turn immediately, right? What will happen is there is no super elevation provided. See here what will happen. So it is taking a turn now. No super elevation is there. So it skids and goes away. That is what is the pull outwards, right? This is when there is no super elevation provided. Now see here, the outer edge is raised. Can you see the inclination? Okay, now see here, without compromising, the vehicle smoothly took a turn and again changed its direction. So this is what is superelevation. Now refer this figure on the right hand side corner, top one, the green line. See here, the road width is same, this gradually increase attains maximum, then it gradually takes the same thickness as it is taking in the first part. Now see here, vehicle traveling along a straight road, the road thickness is same on both sides. Have a look at that right hand side figure. Yeah, it took a turn without compromising its speed and it went away. So this is what is a function of super elevation. I hope you are clear with what is the functioning of super elevation. Okay, next, moving on to deriving a relation of centrifugal force and centripetal acceleration. look at figure A. So point A is having velocity VA and point B is having velocity VB, separated by distance DS, and the shift of angle is d theta. So assuming that the vehicle is traveling with a constant velocity, we say that velocity at A and velocity at B is same. So refer figure B. So velocity VB is equal to V, VA is equal to V, and change in velocity is dV. So from figure B, so velocity VA is equal to VB, velocity VA is equal to VB, that is equal to V. Object is moving with constant speed. So dV is equal to what? V into dt. So dV is from figure B, velocity into d theta. Then similarly from figure A, dV is equal to what? V into dS by R. Right. Now we know that acceleration is equal to what? Velocity upon time. So we already have derived what is value of dV, which is V by R into dS. Substitute that in this equation. So we'll get V by R into dS by dt. But we know that dS by dt is distance upon time, is nothing but velocity. So in place of dS by dt, I'll substitute it with V. So we are left with V square by R. So acceleration is what? V square by R. For equilibrium condition, the centripetal force, that is inward force and outward force, should be same. Then the vehicle will not undergo any kind of skidding or overturning. So we'll equate centripetal force equal to centrifugal force. So force is equal to what? Mass into acceleration, Newton's second law. Then mass is mass of the object or vehicle. Acceleration is from that we have derived is from equation 1, V square by R. So m V square by R, or in place of m you can substitute it with weight, considering the effect of acceleration due to gravity. So we have a relation W is equal to what? M into G. So M is equal to what? W by G. Substitute in place of M, substitute W by G. So F is equal to what? W V square upon GR, which is a relation for centrifugal force and centripetal acceleration. Moving on to next. Okay. So before we go with the next derivation, let me explain you the small concept of moment. So moment is nothing but a rotation effect caused on the object. Moment is a rotation effect caused on the object about any particular arbitrary point given. Now look from figure 1, a nut and a spanner is provided. From that dotted line is a point where we need to create a rotation of the object, that is to tighten the nut or to loosen the nut. So we cannot apply force there to cause a rotation, we have to apply it at some distance. So I have applied it at some distance from that point, which is distance L, and I have applied force which is acting downwards. So moment basically is defined as force into perpendicular distance. Now force P is force, and its perpendicular distance is what? The force, the distance that is perpendicular to P is what? L. So if I take a product of P into L, I'll get what is a moment or rotation about that particular nut. Now here we have two conditions. Rotating the spanner in the direction of clock and rotating the spanner opposite to the direction of clock. If I rotate it in the direction of clock, see the second figure, it will tighten the nut. So that rotation along with the direction of clock, we always take it as positive moment or positive rotation. To loosen the nut, I have to rotate it in opposite direction, that is against the direction of clock. Then that will create loosening of nut. And that moment we call it as anti-clockwise moment. Anti-clockwise moment. And it is taken as negative. Hope you are clear with this. So moving on to next derivation. So reaction of vehicle moving on a level circular path. Right. So from the figure, the vehicle is subjected to weight W acting downwards. The wheels are point A and B, which are subjected to reaction RA and RB, separated by distance 2B. So the vehicle is rotating with respect to center O, which is at a radius of R, and centrifugal force is WV square upon GR. Now consider, okay, one more thing. This friction force F and friction force B. Now, for a vehicle to be in equilibrium, the weight should be acting downwards. Friction force Fa and Fb are acting, reactions are acting upwards, and centrifugal force is acting radially outwards. Apply conditions of equilibrium. Summation H is equal to 0. Then we have W V square by Gr minus F A minus Fb equal to 0. Then since there are no known thing, so we'll mark that as equation 1. Moving on to next condition, summation V equal to 0. So reaction Ra and Rb are acting upwards and W is acting downwards. So W I'll take on the other side, it will be positive. So Ra plus Rb is equal to W. Two unknowns cannot be solved, mark it as equation 2. The third condition of equilibrium, what I was talking was the rotation effect of the object. Now, since object has a tendency to overturn, means it has rotation effect. So applying third condition of equilibrium, that is summation of moment about any arbitrary point equal to 0. So we'll consider point A where sum of all the moment is equal to 0. So when I say moment about A is 0, then what will be Ra? Ra will be also equal to 0 because there is no perpendicular distance for Ra, because Ra and point A are at same point. So Ra is equal to 0. Now what will be the rotation caused by Rb about point A? So Rb will rotate anti-clockwise with respect to point A. Rb will rotate anti-clockwise with respect to point A. So how? I'll show you. Now point A is here, point B is here. So this is Rb and this distance is what? 2b. Now about this point, Rb will rotate like this. So Rb is rotating anti-clockwise. Rb is rotating anti-clockwise. So it is what? Rb is the force and perpendicular distance is what? 2b. Right? So that point I'll write here, Rb into 2b. So here they have considered anti-clockwise rotation as positive and clockwise rotation as negative. So it all depends on how you assume the rotation. So we'll go according to them. So Rb into perpendicular distance is 2b. Now similarly, I hope you understood this part. So this is the vehicle, so weight is acting, so weight is acting downwards like this. Point A is here, this total is how much? 2B. This is how much? B, half of that, center. So this is W. How is this rotating about point A now? Point A, it will rotate like this. So rotation is, force is what? W, and perpendicular distance is what? Perpendicular distance is B. So it is W into B. So here they have taken it as negative, so it is minus W into B. Similarly, centrifugal force centrifugal force, this is weight, so this is vehicle, point A is here. So centrifugal force is acting like this, and distance of that centrifugal force from point A is what? H. So the centrifugal force will rotate how? From about point A, it will rotate like this. So it is rotating clockwise, so force is F, which is W V square by Gr, and perpendicular distance is H. So we have done it here. So doing that, so take these two terms on the other side, so you are left with Rb. Take 2b here, so Wb upon 2b, bb cancels, you are left with W by 2. So here 2b is added. So what is common between these two? W by 2 is common. Take W by 2 common, you are left with the remaining terms. So get what is reaction Rb. Substitute that equation or value of Rb in equation 2. So W minus Rb, you will get what is Ra. So please solve this. then you will understand. Okay, so moving on to next, the main derivation, that is relation for super elevation. So again, considering the vehicle traveling on a circular path, the centrifugal force is acting outwards, weight is acting downwards, width of the road B and elevation is M, point M and N is taken as E. Theta is the angle of superelevation and small e is the rate of superelevation. So one thing to remember here, since the value of theta is very small, the width OM and ON are same. Since the value of theta is very small, negligible, ON is equal to what? ON. OM is equal to ON. Okay. Again, moving on with using the conditions of equilibrium, let us sum up all the forces in horizontal direction. Now, what are the forces in horizontal direction? Look from the figure. One force is horizontal, that is F is equal to WV square upon GR. Acting rightwards, positive. Acting rightwards, so positive. Then, the reaction is making perpendicular to the inclined plane. So, inclined plane is like this. So, surface is inclined like this. Reaction is acting here. So, this is inclined with respect to theta. So, this is R. So, when you resolve this, so your horizontal component of reaction will be like this. Vertical component of reaction will be like this. So, this is R sine theta and this is R cos theta. So, R sine theta is negative and this is positive. Okay, now W V square upon GR minus R sine theta, as I showed you there. So R sine theta keep as it is, W V square upon GR goes on the other side, it becomes minus, minus minus cancels. So we are left with equation 1. Similarly, sum of all the forces in Y direction or vertical direction, V equal to 0. W is acting downwards, so minus W plus R cos theta. So R cos theta is equal to W. Equate equation 1 and 2, that is divide 1 and 2, you will get R sin theta upon R cos theta equal to, write these two terms, W V square upon GR divided by W. So R cancels, sin by cos is tan, W V square upon GR divided by W, W cancels, we are left with V square upon GR. So from triangle OMN, I'll show you here. So from triangle OMN, so this is point O, this is M and this is N. This value is E. So as I said, this value of theta is very small. This B is equal to what? This B. So that is OM is equal to what? ON. So theta is what? So I know what is E, I know what is B. Means I am interested in finding out what is value of E. So I should use relation tan theta is equal to what? Opposite by base, that is MN by ON, which is E by B. Okay, let's have a look at the derivation now. So from this triangle, tan theta is MN by ON. So MN is what? E. ON is what? B, since theta is very small. Now equate equation 3 and 4, you'll get what is value of E. Now when you are dealing with vehicles on road, you have to go with using relation first one, that is E equal to V square B upon GR. If you are dealing with finding the superelevation with respect to railways, then you have to go with V square G upon small GR, where G indicates the gauge distance of the railways and B indicates the width of the road. I hope you are clear with this. And out up till here, please feel free to clarify it. Okay, moving further, we are done with all the concepts of superelevation. Let's take up a simple examples on superelevation. Okay, the first problem reads, a circular automobile test track has a radius of 200 meters. The design of the track is such that when a car travels at a speed of 72 km/h, the force between the automobile and track is normal to the surface of track. find the angle of bank or superelevation. Okay, so one more thing to tell here is superelevation has some other names. They are also called by some other names. What is commonly called as superelevation, it is also called as bank, or it is also called as cant. All three means the same. Okay, let's list down the given data. So given data, radius is 200 meters, speed is 72 kmph. These are the two datas given. Now with respect to the given data, so you have to maintain only one unit. Now speed is given in kilometer per hour and radius is given in meters. So you have to convert the speed V, which is 72 kmph, in meter per second. So to convert that to meter per second, we have to multiply 72 into 1000. Why 1000? Because why 1000? Because 1 kilometer is 1000 meters. So this is 72 into 1000 divided by per hour. We have to convert that to per second. So 1 hour is 60 minutes into 60 seconds. So we'll get the answer as 20 meter per second. This is one way, or you have to directly multiply 72 into 5 by 18. You will get 20 meter per second. So this is one way of converting, right? Okay, once we are done with conversions, you know that tan theta is V square upon GR. So substitute value of the given terms, V square is 20 square divided by 9.81 into 200. You will get value of theta. So this theta is nothing but, it is finding this value. So this is inclined like this. You found out this value of theta, which is 11.53 degrees. I hope you are clear with this problem. Moving on to next. So I have taken one problem on railway. So it reads, a railway track with gauge 1.68 meter carries a locomotive weighing 1000 kN running on a curved track at 60 kmph of radius 800 meter. Determine the superelevation of the track. Also determine the superelevation of the track, and also determine the lateral thrust exerted on outer rail if the speed of the locomotive is changed to 80 kmph. Okay, firstly, the train is traveling with a speed of 60 kmph. You have to find out what is the superelevation required to reduce the effect of centrifugal force. Firstly, list down what are the given terms. So gauge distance is given. So gauge distance here indicates gauge distance means this is like this. This is the railway track. These are the tires. So this value is nothing but your gauge track. Gauge distance. This value is given as 1.68 meters. Right. That value is given as 1.68 meters. So convert again, radius is given 800 meters, velocity is given 60 kmph. So 60 into 5 by 18, you will get in meter per second. Directly go with using the relation tan theta is equal to what? V square upon GR. We know what is value of V, we know G is 9.81, radius is 800. So the value of theta obtained is 2.033 degrees. Also we know that tan theta is equal to what? Superelevation by the width. So here width is nothing but your gauge. So this value is known. So we found out what is theta. So we are required to find out what is this value of E for a given gauge distance. So gauge distance, this and this is same. So tan theta is equal to what? E by G. So we are required to finding E. So this will be what? G into tan theta. So G is given 1.68 into tan theta is 2.033. So we'll end up with answer in 0.005964. This is in meters. 0.05964 meters. So that 0.05964 is in meters. You have to convert that to mm, multiply with 1000. So it will be 59.64. Okay, so the required superelevation is found out. one more condition he has given. Determine the lateral thrust exerted on the outer rail if the speed of the locomotive is changed to 80 kmph. It means what? What is the force exerted on the outer wheel if the speed which was 60 initially is increased to 80? So you have to find out what is this lateral force F. From the figure you can see it is acting in the downward direction. You have to find out what is that force. So speed 80, convert that to meter per second. So apply summation horizontal force equal to 0. Sum of all force in horizontal is equal to 0. Minus F because it is acting leftwards. W V square upon GR making an angle theta. So W V square upon GR cos theta. Then weight is also making an angle theta. So W sine theta. So acting downwards, so minus. So substitute all the known terms. Only F is unknown. So you get what is value of F. Hope you are clear with this part. If you like this video, please hit a like button and support my page. Thank you.